today is an enhanced day. But first, I have to go get some coffee. Today, it's all about enhancing. Got my coffee. We're gonna enhance that Urban Mandala that I worked on the other day. Just do final little tweaks to really make things sing and come out of the image. One of the ways that I want to develop these mandalas is kind of by accident, kind of just getting the idea and executing them on the fly, the way I kind of film these vlogs. You have an idea in mind of what it's gonna be, but it's not like every shot is planned out like a film. Okay, so I'm gonna work on that linked smart object that the mandala is pretty much composed of. One of the things I didn't like that I did yesterday was this little stroke around the edges, so I'm gonna kind of turn that off. I don't think that works with the image. I'm gonna kind of start at the top and maybe figure out what spots which. Now, kind of, I approach this whole project kind of the way I approach doing a vlog in a lot of ways. I just use the images that I shot to create the project. So whatever I shot during the week is pretty much all I have to work on or use for the project. So it limits myself so that I know that, hey, you know what? Next week will be a different project. So I'm gonna work on that and shoot new images for that project later. Oh, there's another stupid email from TripAdvisor who likes to tell me how often I don't go on vacation because I'm so busy working. Right now I'm just doing, I have a layer, a soft light layer, and I'm just kind of burning in, painting with a little black to enhance some of these nuts and bolts and darken some of these features. Kind of go through this and tweak the mask, get things working a little bit better. I know that in the overall mandala, you don't really see a lot of this smaller detail. So some of it just needs a little bit of love and care. I'm not gonna be super, super specific with some of these pieces because it just doesn't really need to be. I'm going to attach that to this, so, you know, just little things to kind of pop things out. Do like the way the metal and the brick, so I do like the way the graffiti kind of crosses over from one spot to the other, but what I don't necessarily like is the way kind of this nodule didn't work properly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just retouch out some of those pieces, some of those bolts. Like, I know that most of this stuff is just kind of, you know, going to be not so obvious to most people who are viewing this project, but to me, just all these little refinements, these little details should help to make this be a little bit more harmonious without having all these kind of weird Photoshop-y era things. I'm just doing really kind of a retouching thing. This is more of a practice for future ones. You know, I think if you do a number of these, if you do any type of piece of artwork over and over again, all of a sudden it becomes a style. You develop a style at doing them. And then you get a clearer vision of what you want to accomplish in these pieces of artwork. And since this is the first one that I'm ever doing, I believe that I'll learn a
to shoot it better or shoot different projects, shoot different elements for these projects so that they will yield a result that I'm looking for. But I do like the idea of just being limited to what you shoot during the week. It does give you a challenge. So I'm gonna go back in. I'm gonna take a kind of a soft brush, just kind of work this the way I think it should work. Those brushes are really cool. You can check them out, but the only issue is you really kind of want to play with them for a while. I'm not an illustrator by any shape or form, but I can see their value. Ooh, nice. I made a bolt there. What I'm trying to do is just kind of make these all work so they feel a little bit more uniform, so they don't feel like someone hacked them together. So you can really get a sense of that these were all, that this was one piece, all designed to work together, and that these, that the graffiti was kind of meant to do what it's doing. In the same token, I kind of want to keep the brick. So there's parts of the brick that I want to show through, and I want it to feel like it's part of the metal, even though it doesn't really make sense, right? So I'm just cleaning up some of these masks that were pretty, that I did quite rushed yesterday. Just gonna soften them so they blend better. I do like that this window and the main shot kind of looks really just bizarre in a lot of ways. Alright, so those pieces are going over it. I like that this piece is going over here. I'm not sure about this piece. I also like that this piece is working, so I just wanna, you know, it's all about the fine little details that work together in these kind of projects. You just play. Painting happy little graffiti trees. Also, I think that this window needs a little bit of pop. Now, cool thing about the way I've dealt with this project, these are all linked smart objects, so I can just double click on one and create a new folder with a curve adjustment inside, and I can just go in and give this a bit more contrast, which I think is kind of necessary. I think that'll help kind of sell that this is a weird window on the side of a building. You know what also is cool? That star is very cool. I might use that elsewhere. And then when I save and close, it'll automatically update in this file. See? I'm looking to get some more depth in this, but I'm also looking to refine some of those funky masks that I was doing. This one, I wasn't so happy with this one. I kind of like the shot. It's just the way it works. I like the juxtaposition of it. I like that it's off angle compared to everything else. It just needs to be a bit sharper. So with the pen tool, or with the brush tool, you can click on one point and then hold down shift and click on another point, and it's going to give you a straight line between those points, which is always kind of cool. Yeah, so this piece, I really like the way it's hitting the lip, but I think it needs to be a bit smaller. So I think I want to see the bottom of that lip. And I'm wondering, what do you think? Do you think we should have a little bit more lip? No, it should be in the center of the nose. It should feel like that. Maybe this can come up a little. Kind I like that. Maybe this little piece, right? That little piggy. Maybe that can finish off this black area, right? Maybe we give her a full lip back. See, I kept that solid red layer underneath so that I could turn off layers and whatever background is showing me still have at least some red in it. And then I can also see the errors or the mistakes. Cool little trick is that if you're on the move tool, the V to hit, get to the move tool, and you hold down control, you can ask it which layer am I on. Color fill is the background. There's two layers here. This is the topmost one, right? And yep, it's that one. So I like. I like the red spray paint on this layer, but I don't want it to cover up as much. I want it to be a little bit more defined when it's hitting this one point. Definitely a little bit more happy with that. I like this piece right here. So let's see. I'm gonna go into the, whoa. It's hard to tell where that original is, right? All right, I think that's here. So I'm gonna go in here. I'm gonna do a new layer, set to soft light. I'm gonna paint with black or white to lighten up, to darken. Black to darken, and I'm just gonna kind of burn in some of these details. I want this to stand out a little bit better. A bigger brush, I could set it to like 30%, and then maybe 20%. Kind of looking back at it to get a better sense of how it's going to read and really get a better understanding of your work sometimes when you work away from it. That's pretty good. Let's see how that works in the other shot. Oh, so much nicer, right? So much cooler. All right, so maybe we need to do that to some of these other pieces. I do like the way this doubles up. I like the red. The eye is kind of amazing. This door is working, but I think it needs something. Oh, so this door is right here. Let's start with just a little color correction. I'm just gonna use the contrast, just a hint. I think I'm also going to over sharpen this paint, just for some of those crazy detail. I'm also going to add another soft light layer so I can dodge and burn and bring some of these things out. See, I'm being very sloppy with the way I'm working just because sometimes when you're too refined, especially on a piece like this, it just screams overworked. And I don't want to overwork this. I just want to work it just enough to make sure that what I want to come out comes out. Just that little bit. See that? They're really cool. All right, let's see. I'm kind of not loving this thing. Where was that star? No. Oh, Frankenstein. Love puss. Love that. I'm gonna have to use that in another shot. No. So yesterday I silhouetted out this pipe because I was thinking about using it for like an accent piece on the top. I'm actually going to crop this down because I don't really need much else. Crop, clear.
All right, so
Sorry, I didn't chat most of the process up. It's just one of those things, once you get into the zone, you just stay in the zone. So from far away, this thing looks pretty interesting. You kind of, you know, just look at it like a regular mandala, but it's, but you notice that something's interesting about this. Okay, I think I've taken this as far as I can for today. I might still do some tweaks on it later, but I think that's it. I think this is a pretty interesting format for it. When you look at it small, it just looks like some type of normal mandala made by just normal people, but as you zoom in and see the pieces and how the pieces go together, I'm loving the lock and the doorknobs. Just so many interesting pieces that fall into the right spaces. Loving it. Love how the nose and the face comes together, and throwing this on an overlay layer really kind of made it sing. And that star. So glad I grabbed that star. Very cool.
So let me know down in the comments what you think about these images that I've created. They're kind of satisfying in a lot of ways. They hit a lot of and tick a lot of the points on my brain for creating things out of nothing. They're really satisfying that itch to create something, and having the limitations of just the images that I shoot in the beginning of the week to create something by the end of the week. Really, really satisfying. Let me know what you think down below, and if you do like it, give it a thumbs up. That would be fantastic. Subscribe if you haven't yet, and I'm gonna be doing these once a week over the next, hopefully, 10 to 20 or 30 weeks. Remember to inspire, create, and enhance every day. Have a good night, and I'll see you in the next video.